Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So I am continuing with the series of MCQs on Python. So today's discussion is on Python strings. So MCQs on Python strings with answers. You can check out the description box for other Python topics as well. So here the first one is, how do you declare strings in Python? So using single quotes, double quotes, triple quotes. So in Python we can use all these three ways of representing strings in Python. So the answer is all. So what will be the output of the Python code? str1 equal to 6 by 4. So here 6 by 4 is represented in double quotes, so we are printing str1 in double quotes. So it's not going to print this 6 by 4 because here str1 itself is in double quotes. So it will just print this str1. We need to be careful to see whether the variable is given or the variable given in double quotes. If the variable given in double quotes, the value will not be printed. Instead, whatever the string that is there in double quotes will be printed. Which of the following will result in an error? str1 equal to Python. So here printing str1 of 2, that is the third character printing, it's not an error. Printing str1 of 0 to 9, that is printing from first character to ninth character, that is also not error. But trying to modify the second character in the str1 is wrong because string is immutable. So when we say immutable, we cannot alter its content. So it's B. Which of the following is false? So string is immutable, it's a true statement. Capitalize function in string is used to return a string by converting each word first character into uppercase. This is the wrong statement because capitalize function will be turning into sentential case, which indicates only the first word in a sentence will be made upper character, that to the first character. So this is a false statement. What will be the output of the below Python code? str1 equal to information, print str1 of 2 to 8, that is from index 2 to index 7. So whatever the end value will be given, that is exclusive, that's not inclusive. So from index 2 to index 7 characters will be printed, and indexing begins from 0. So here indexing 2 begins from F and indexing 7 ends at T. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So index 7 we have T. So it begins from F and ends at T. So it is format. So what will be the output of below Python code? str1 equal to application, str1 dot replace of small a with capital A. So as said, string is immutable. So when we say immutable, so it's not going to replace anything. So it will be the same application. It's not going to perform any replacing in the original string. If you want, you can assign it to another string. So it will be original string. So here it will be application. Okay, I think while preparing the question I missed out one P. So actually it should be str1 equal to A double P actually. So you can just understand it. So it's a typo error. So it's B. What will be the output of the below Python code? str1 equal to program, print str1 of -6. So in forward direction, indexing begins from 0. In a reverse direction, indexing begins from -1. So here -1 represents M, -2 represents A, -3 represents R, -4 represents G, -5 represents O, -6 represents R. So it is small r. Which of the following will give Simon as output? So here the string is given as John, comma, Simon, comma, Aryan. So comma also is considered here as character. So we are supposed to print Simon and clearly the options represents negative indexes. So we can just start counting in reverse direction with minus 1 as beginning. So minus 1 is n, minus 2 small a, minus 3 y, minus 4 r, minus 5 a, minus 6 comma, so minus 7. We require this minus 7 also to be inclusive, but end will not be included, so we need to give end as up to comma, that indicates minus 6. So here you can understand this is the one which is having minus 6 as the end. So minus 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So capital S represents minus 11 and small n represents minus 7. But we need to give end as plus 1 because end is not inclusive. So we need to give up to comma's index, that is minus 6. So option C is correct. What will the below Python code will return? str1 equal to save paper comma save plants. str1 dot find of save. So basically find function, the find function will return the first occurrence of the given word. So wherever it have begun, it returns the first occurrence. If we use rfind, it will return the last occurrence, that is the rightmost occurrence. That's what this particular find function will tell. So as per the definition, the last option is the correct answer. Here the last option is the correct answer. It returns the first index position of the first occurrence of save in the given string str1. What will the below Python code will return? str1 equal to programming print str1 of 2 colon 8 colon minus 2. So here start is less than end. So 2, which is the start position, is less than the end position 8. Whenever the start value is less than the end value, step should be always positive. Then only we get things displayed in forward direction. Otherwise, we don't get anything displayed. In this case, start value 2 less than end value 8 and step being negative. So nothing will be printed. What will the below Python code will return? So str1 equal to again programming print str1 of 6 colon 1 colon minus 2. So here start is greater than end. Whenever you have start greater than end, then you can have step negative. Then things get displayed in reverse direction. Here index 0 represents capital P, index 1 R, index 2 small o, index 3 G, index 4 R, index 5 A, index 6 M. So from this M up to index 1 with a step of minus 2. So first M will be printed and in reverse a small r will be printed and again in reverse small o will be printed. So that is MRO will be printed in this case. What will the below Python code will return? Programming and print str1 of minus 9, minus 4, 2. So here start is minus 9, which is less than the end value minus 4, and step is positive. So in this case, it will print in forward direction. So whenever start is less than end and step is positive, things get displayed in forward direction. Whenever start is greater than end and step is negative, things get displayed in reverse direction. So in this case, from index minus 9. So indexing begins from minus 1 in reverse direction. So here minus 9 means it is small o in reverse direction and with a step of 2. So that means alternate characters. So small o will be printed and next small r will be printed and next small m will be printed. And then that's it. So end is reached. So only o, r, m will be printed. What will the below Python code will return? str1 programming is print str1 of minus 8, minus 4, minus 2. So in this case, again, it will not print anything because as mentioned, so start is less than end, but step is negative. So nothing will print it. What will the below Python code will return? str1 equal to pynative, str2 equal to abc, pynative, xyz, print str2 of 1 equal to str1. So here str2 is an array. So where str2 of 0 represents abc, str2 of 1 represents pynative, str2 of 2 represents xyz. So we are checking with respect to double equal to. So double equal to will check only with respect to the contents. It will check only with respect to contents. So here pi native both with respect to case also are same. So this particular statement will return boolean true. And next str2 of 1 is str1. So here in this case we are asking for the identity check, and both are again true. That's why it will return again true only for this also. So that means both will be returning true as the answer. So here it is. What will the below Python code will return? Str1 equal to my salary is 7000. Print str1 dot is all num. So we are checking whether this particular str1 string is containing all alphabets and digits in the string. So here in this case, if you observe, this is having separators, and in this case, in this particular my, there is no digit. In this salary, there is no digit. In this is, there is no digit. In this 7000, there is no alphabet. So it should contain mix of both. The string should contain mix of both. In this case, each and every independent string, again, individual word is not a mix of both. So that's why this particular thing will return false. So if it is like salary 5, a combination of both characters and digits in the same word, then it will return true. So what will the below Python code will return? Str1 equal to welcome, str1 of colon 6 plus space and world. There is a space also here. So str1 of colon 6, that means start is not given, which by default treats 0 as the starting position. So from index 0 to index 5, because 6 is the end value, which should not be inclusive. So from index 0 to 5, that means small e is not included. Small e is not included. So we need to consider up to welcome without e, and then space and world to be appended. So it is C. So what will the below Python code will return? So str1 is my salary is 7000, str2 is 7000. Now print str1 dot is digit. So it's not containing completely digits. That's why str1, when we are asking for is digit, it will return false because it's containing alphabets also. And next str2 dot is digit. Yes, str2 is not containing any alphabets and it's containing purely digits, so it will return true. So it is false and true. What will the below Python code will return? S equal to hello, S plus equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3. So straight away it is an error, because you cannot concatenate digits or integers to a string. So it is error. What will the below Python code will return? Str1 equal to xyz, xyyz, xyz, xz, xyy. So we are asking to print str1 dot count of xyy, comma 2 comma 11. That means we are asking it to return how many times this xyy occurred from index 2 to index 11. So we are not just asking to return the number of occurrences of this particular string xyy in str1, but also we are specifying to count it only in between index 2 to 11. So there is actually two xyy's in this str1. If you observe, there are two xyy in the beginning and at the end. But when we are asking it to return the number of occurrences of this particular xyy in str1 from 2 to 11, in that case, from index 2 to 11, that means last but one character, up to the last but one character, in that case, there are no xyy appeared in the given range. So it will return 0. What will the below Python code will return? So the sum of 2 and 0 is 1. These are not the numbers, these are the placeholders. These are the placeholders. So dot format method, and format method is taking 3. Parameters 2, 10, 12, where 2 represents the place of 0, 10 represents the place of 1, 12 represents the place of 2. So in this case, we are given the places something like this: first, second place, next, 0th place, next, first place. So in this case, 2 is representing 0th place, 10 is representing the first place, 12 is representing the second place. So it will return the sum of 12 and 2 is 10. It's not correct statement, but still, as per the given format order, this is the answer. What will the below Python code will return? str1 equal to 2.5, print str1 dot is alpha. So we are verifying if it is alphabets. So straight away, we can tell it's not alphabet, so we can say false. What will the below Python code will return? So hello 0 and 1, so where 0 and 1 represents the placeholders, dot format of, we need to observe such things carefully, because here foo comma bin, whatever it is given, they are given in a parenthesis which represents a tuple. That means we are passing only one tuple. We are passing only one tuple. These are not the placeholders of 0 and 1. This entire foo bin parenthesis represents one tuple which represents placeholder of 0. So here placeholder value of 1 is missing. Placeholder value of 1 is missing. We need to be careful with such statements by observing the parenthesis. So here there is only one placeholder value given. The second placeholder is missing, so it will be error. What will the below Python code will return? str1 equal to my name is James Bond. We need to be careful with the capital letters. So print str1 dot capitalize. So earlier at one of the bit I have already explained, capitalize will return only the first words, first character as capital. So the answer is B, because only the first words, first character of a sentence will be made capital by the capitalize. What will the below Python code will return? My name is James Bond. So title. So title case, what it will do is, it will make each word's first character capital. It will make each word's first character capital. So in this case, A is the correct answer. What will the below Python code will return? D equal to 83:80, 72:66. That means we are defining a dictionary. And then S equal to, hi Sam is the string. Print S dot translate of D. That means we are passing the dictionary as the parameter for the translate function, which we are applying it on string S. That means whatever the character that is having ASCII value 83 will be translated to the character with ASCII value 80. That's what this particular dictionary key value pair represents. Likewise, whatever the ASCII character 72 is there in the string, that will be translated with the ASCII character 66. So in this case, H is the capital letter whose ASCII value is 83, which we are asking it to be replaced by ASCII character 80, that is capital P. Likewise, sorry, it is 83, it is capital S, that is being replaced by capital P. Likewise, 72 ASCII character is capital H, which will be replaced by ASCII character 66, that is capital B. So it will be the first one, that is by Pam. Instead of hi Sam, it will be coming by Pam, something like this. So we are specifying in terms of dictionary which character should be translated to which character. That's what we are specifying as key value pair. And then that particular dictionary what you have defined, you are going to pass it as the parameter to the translate function on which you wanted to apply.